Hi there. Today's is a special episode, and not just because it's gone up a couple of days early. It's almost Mabon, so I thought I'd release a video on that. I think I've released something like this over on my blog, but here we are. Regardless, a number of witchy festivals don't fall on the same day every year, unlike Christmas, for example, which happens on the 25th of December every year because it falls under the Gregorian solar calendar, which is 365 days long. Many Wiccan festivals, however, fall under the lunar calendar, though, which is only 354 days long, so they fall on slightly differing days every year. This year, 2021, Mabon begins on Tuesday the 21st of September and lasts until Wednesday the 29th, but next year, it starts on Wednesday the 21st and ends on Thursday the 29th. This is because the average month in the Gregorian calendar is 30 days long, whereas a lunar month is 29 and a half. See how there would be a very slight difference there? It's at this time of year that the day becomes as long as the night, as the year begins to transition into the later months. This is called an equinox, a word that basically means a time when the day and night are the same length. We get another in the spring, when winter comes to an end and the warmer months come back. It becomes easier to remember the word's meaning by taking the first half of the word equinox and associating it with the word equal. Day and night, equal, see? I'll go over what a solstice is in another video, so be sure to subscribe for that, and leave a like and a comment while you're at it. For now, since we have the equinox part of Mabon out of the way, let's go on to the actual festival part of the festival. Mabon is the Wiccan harvest festival. It's at this time that crops would be reaped, animals would be slaughtered and preserved for the dark months, and thanks would be given to the god and goddess for the success of their harvest, since with winter coming, things were going to get a lot harder in terms of looking for food. An enormous feast would be had at this time too, to celebrate having so much food and the fact that their friends, family, neighbors, were likely to survive the cold months. At the time, it wasn't as simple as popping down the co-op or Tesco or Aldi to pick up a bag of potatoes, a couple of pork chops and some fruit snacks for the kids. Whatever you had or were going to have, you had to grow and rear it yourself, or it was very likely that your family was going to die, so managing to grow enough food and preserve enough meat was a very big deal. People would gather at the dawn of the equinox to watch the sun rise on this special day where the day and night were the same length, and still do, specifically at Stonehenge in England. The Old England. If you wanted to do this to start off your Mabon, there is a way. The Stonehenge website has a page called the Skyscape that shows a live feed directly from Stonehenge. I'll leave links to that below. While I would like to witness it myself, I am indeed a night owl. Mornings don't work well for me. Thankfully, squirreling away food isn't quite as necessary these days, unless we need to start prepping for another lockdown. Imagine the preparing you would have to do if we went into lockdown in September and wouldn't be allowed back into the shops, mask or no mask, until February. That's how big a deal it was. Regardless, we don't need to gather now, so the importance of a harvest festival isn't as great as it was back then, but it's still something that we can choose to celebrate, to mark the changing of the year, as it is important, especially these days when it's been so easy during lockdown to lose track of time, to take notice of nature's changes and to be thankful for it and its cycle. As for how we can go about celebrating it today, there are a few ways to go about that. First up, you can make an altar. It doesn't need to be enormous. It could be a corner of a windowsill or the entire dining room table. You'll want to decorate it with foods and items of an autumnal nature. Apples, root vegetables, pine cones, acorns. Acorns and pine cones can be important ingredients in spell work, so I'll be going on my yearly walk where I specifically look for autumnal spell ingredients to gather, but be careful not to take too much. The birdies need them a lot more than we do. You can light appropriately colored candles as well. Yellow, orange, and brown. Similarly, you can use incenses of an autumnal nature as well, like apple, cinnamon, and sandalwood. Additionally, you can include prayers of thanks to whichever deity that you follow for everything that you have. Your home, your bed, the ability to buy food, as well as asking for continued good fortune. Now, I know that a good number of baby witches are still in the broom closet, so I know you're thinking, the people I live with don't know I'm a witch, and I don't want them to, so how can I celebrate Mabon? Well, I have you covered. First up, you can wear the colors. The colors I mentioned for the candles, you can wear them. Any item of clothing would do. A shirt, your trousers, or even your underpants and socks. It doesn't need to be a big, obvious item. You could choose out a ring or pendant that has those colors as well. Amber, citrine, smoky quartz, for example. This way, you get to observe Mabon and go unnoticed at the same time. There are other ways to celebrate it too. Do you have any scented candles? Cinnamon's pretty common in scented candles. Sandalwood and patchouli as well. If candles aren't an option, you can go with a similarly scented air freshener. I'm currently using a pine-scented one by Febreze. They do a spiced apple one too. I know, a few witches watching this are thinking, don't you know that's bad for the environment? Yes, I do, but not everyone can afford or get access to the vegan options. We're all just doing our best. Next up is foods. This one is easy to do, since a lot of vegetables become available at this time: carrots, spinach, broccoli, peas, sweet potato, aubergine, the list goes on and on and on. But what can I make with that? I'll bet you're asking. I've got that too: carrot cake, baked sweet potatoes, ham and pea soup, cheese and broccoli quiche, and my recent favorite, eggplant pizzas. It's incredible. Anything with pecans will work too, and I know that a number of you enjoy pumpkin spice coffee. Pumpkin spice anything would do here, including pumpkin pie. Personally, I've been getting the itch to bake recently, so I might make a coffee and pecan cake to have for pudding on Mabon after a dinner of eggplant pizza. Do you have a fruit bowl, by the way? Put a couple of apples in there and boom. Mabon altar that is completely unnoticeable to non-witches. Assuming you drink alcohol, you could have a couple of glasses of cider too. I personally don't drink, not because I consider my body a temple or anything. I'll repeat: coffee and pecan cake. Carrot cake, quiche. I am very much a foodie. But, for those of us who don't drink, or for baby witches who are perhaps too young, non-alcoholic cider would do. Apple juice, apple soda, appetizer, apple tango. There's lots of different options. There are pear variants for these as well, pear being another autumn fruit. Grapes are apparently another in-season fruit, so plain old wine would work. There's cranberry juice too. Since Mabon is on a Tuesday this year, this video has had to go up early, rather than my normal Wednesday, which means there likely won't be a video for Wednesday, but for certain, my upload schedule will return to normal for this coming Saturday when the next episode of Gems in 60 Seconds will go live. Thanks for watching and please, leave a like, a comment and subscribe for future content. Let me know below what you're interested in, what you would like to see, and in the meantime, I want you to stay safe. Blessed be.